This is Agent 44327, requesting permission to bring back life form Dr. Cranky for further investigation.
Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory, making the next video in the series that we've got going on here. This one we are going to talk about the process of monetization and why you want to monetize. Now, you need to go in there and read all the information that YouTube has on the process. They'll let you know exactly how many subscribers you need, how many views in total you need. You also need to fill out an application to become a YouTube partner, which, I mean, it's got a lot of information, and it also has a lot of goodies, including all sorts of perks, like allowing you to, I believe they allow you to make longer videos, and also they give you access to a lot of their copyright-free music, and which is a big deal, and it's one of the things that tripped us up initially. As I said previously, I started back in 2008 with a slideshow. Actually, it wasn't a slideshow, it was a live video of a VW Beetle diorama that I had done that I love, and I had Barry White in the background, and they quickly turned that down and eventually killed it. Rightly so, you know. I didn't have permission to use Barry White's music, so you know, why should the video play? So immediately we started thinking about, do we want to create video content for free? I mean, literally just for free. You put all the work in there, you put all your money in terms of gear and tripod. Even if you're paying for your phone, a little tripod's going to cost you $5.99, right? $9.99, but then you didn't need one, but now you need one for YouTube and blah blah blah. Next thing you know, you've got a lot of expenses, and you're setting up your shop and all of that good stuff. So, you know, the basic question you need to ask yourself is, do you want to create free content so that YouTube can run it and then eventually run ads on your video and make all the money for themselves? And again, there isn't that much money, but you know, if you give them all your content and they use it, then they're the ones making the pennies, not you. So it's something you need to figure out. And this is, you know, this conversation lives outside of the whole philosophical question of, you know, what if you're building models, do you want to create content for free and to help other builders? And of course you want to do that, right? But by the same token, you don't want to have YouTube, right, make all the money when you can in fact monetize. If you follow some basic guidelines and rules, you can become a partner and you can monetize and you can grow your channel, and you know, it's a beautiful thing. And then eventually you'll start earning some cash, Ola, through Google, right? So I mean, it's a slow process. It takes a while. They've bumped up the rules to make it a little bit tougher, or to make people wait a little bit longer. You know, you have to commit to making a regular content, you know. And here in the laboratory, we take big chunks of time off. I mean, we normally take the holidays off, and then we also take the summer off. But in between, you know, we do provide quite a bit. And again, I'm not saying that we're one of the most prolific channels out there, but we do make a steady content on the channel, and it also ties into the whole idea of having seasons. That way, you know, you have a spring season and you have a fall season that coincides with what I do in real life for a living. So That's not, you know, that's neither here nor there, but you have to think about all of these things. The one thing that's going to kill you right away is if you get three strikes because you are you're violating copyright laws, right? One of the ways that they've made it tougher now is that they have better filters, and they'll catch you right away, and they'll send you a strike if you really can't claim the copyright. They'll get you, and then I think three strikes and you are out. Basically, that's what that means. And then you have to start all over again. So these are matters for you to think about them. They're all up to each individual. You know, what do you want and what do you want to do, right? And if it's okay with you that you you make the content and you give it to them for free, basically, and you let them run with it, then it's, that's your personal take on it. But I learned very quickly, and in part thanks to YouTube, hassling me over music and content and all of that, I learned very quickly that if I was going to put the time in, then I was also going to make the pennies, right? And it is that, but pennies add up, right? So think about the process, and then go on over to YouTube and Creator Studio and look at all the information. The application is readily available, so you can file it. You can file the application and get that in the works, right? And give them a clear idea of what you are going to do. Ultimately, we declare this channel to be an educational channel, which is, it mostly is. But over the time that we've been on YouTube, they've tightened up in terms of the content, right? And also, because if you're going to monetize, that means that they are going to have general sponsors, right, running videos and ads on your video, on your work. And so they're going to want to make sure that you're not doing horrible videos on whatever it is that they deem obscene or not acceptable for the community. So it's a binding document, and you govern yourself accordingly. It's one of the reasons why we try to keep the channel as clean as possible, but we will talk about that in the next video when we start talking about what kind of sponsorships are available and what you get for it, and et cetera, right? And so we'll talk about that in the next one. So if you want to monetize, look at the information that YouTube provides and read it carefully, and then ask yourself exactly what kind of content creator you are going to be within the within the confines of the channel that you're trying to create. And think about it. Give yourself a little bit of time. You do have plenty of time before they actually say yes, and then they welcome you in, etc., etc. Anyway, let me know what you think in the comments below, and keep watching. There's going to be more content coming up. All right, my friends, stay tuned in for more.